In the previous use case, we went through process discovery for the insurance company's claims to settlement process. Now, let's look at how advanced analytical features coupled with Copilot and AI can help audit the process, identify compliance issues, and mitigate them through early detection and monitoring the improvement progress. With Power Automate Process Mining, not only do we have a great data ingestion and out-of-box dashboard experience coupled with Copilot, we also have advanced analytics capabilities with the same great Copilot experience. Let's take a look. In the process map view, we can see the same end-to-end insurance claims process which we collated from different sources in use case 1. To get a better understanding of the process, we can take a hierarchical approach. I can cluster my activities based on stage, which drastically simplifies the process map. I see there are 3 stages to the claims to settlement process: initial processing, investigation and review, and finally, settlement and resolution. Just like with the base process map, I can see the cases that flow through each of these stages, including the fact that some claims go directly from initial processing to resolution. If I just expand one of these stages, I can see the activities within that stage and how it interacts with other stages. It is important that all claims that are settled go through the investigation and review stage, and thankfully I see that all claims that go directly from initial processing to resolution are either withdrawn or rejected. I can expand all stages and the process map will show all the interactions of activities within each stage as well as between stages. I can even reduce the complexity of the process map by cutting some of the edge cases, which makes the overall process map more easily understandable. On top of the frequency, performance, and rework displays I can toggle for my process map, which was also available in the web dashboard, I also have a financial display, which shows the flow of financial values within the process, including the claim amount and also the cost per event, where I see that the costliest activity is investigation. In addition to the process map, we also have the ability to visualize the interactions between resources of the process, which is very important from an auditing and compliance perspective. The social chart view shows me the interactions between various resources in the process, and I see that there's 2 groups of resources that seem to not interact with each other. Let's find out why. Clicking on each resource, I can see detailed stats about the resource from the perspective of frequency, performance, and rework. I can also see the activities for that resource, and here I see this specific resource specializes in coverage checks and does that 100% of the time. Not only can I see activities for each resource, but I can also look from the perspective of any attribute I've ingested. If I look at the handler team attribute, I can see that this resource is part of team B. In fact, all other resources that this resource interacts with are also part of team B, and the other group of resources are part of team A. This is useful information as we dig deeper into compliance issues. For identifying compliance issues, I can ask my Copilot for help. I can ask it about critical activities within my process I should be checking for from a compliance perspective, and it is able to provide a list of activities in my specific process, many of them being check activities like policy, coverage, fraud checks, etc., as well as handler assignment investigation. Because our Copilot combines the most advanced large language model with specific data from your process, it is able to provide insights that combine both elements. With these insights from Copilot, I can now use our comprehensive filtering capability to find non-compliant claims where these crucial activities did not occur before settlement. I will start by filtering only for cases which have been settled. Then, I can use the sequence filter to find instances where critical compliance activities did not occur before settlement. One very useful feature of the app is that it dynamically calculates how many cases will be filtered based on the given filter conditions. So I can see immediately that there are 132 cases where handler was not assigned and investigation was not conducted. Back in the process map, I can look at the filter process flow for those 132 cases and assess the impact by looking at the total amount paid for these non-compliant cases, which amounted to $43.2K. Let's continue. We can go back to filter and keep going down the list of key activities Copilot mentioned and keeping an eye on the bottom to see if the number of cases is greater than zero. Luckily, no issues with fraud checks and coverage checks, but we did find that there were 212 settled cases where FNOL, or First Notice of Loss, fraud and duplicate checks were not conducted. These cases represent 73.2K in financial impact, and sum to over 100K when combined with settlements without investigations. If we switch over to the social chart, we can see that there is a concentration of resources that are involved in these non-compliant cases. And looking at the activities, we can confirm that they are conducting various compliance checks within this process. These are really amazing, actionable insights where through Copilot and advanced filtering, we were able to identify specific claims and specific resources that were resulting in compliance violations. To continue with our compliance investigation, we will shift focus more to the financial side and look at the linked process that drills into the settlement to payment activities, which is mostly coming from the SAP system. We see that in this process, we start with settlement record creation, then the corresponding invoice document creation, approval, and finally payment processing. Let's start by looking at segregation of duties, which is an important compliance gate on the financial side. The goal here is to ensure that the individual creating the settlement doc and the individual approving payment is not the same person. And using the built-in conflict of interest filter, setting these two activities, and checking for resource, we're easily able to detect 165 cases where this is a violation. We can view the filtered process map and filter for the amount as before, and here we can see that a whopping 594K worth of claims were paid without noticing this conflict of interest. We can create a view for this issue as well as other compliance issues we discovered so we can monitor and report on it using Power BI. Finally, let's look at late payments. For insurance companies, timeliness of claim processing and payment is very important from a compliance perspective, and failure to comply may lead to damage to reputation, fines, and other legal repercussions. In order to understand which claims were paid late, we can leverage the app's robust custom metrics capabilities. By comparing the due date set in the system with the due date of the process payment activity, we can create a new case-level metric that is able to identify all instances of on-time and late payment. In addition, to investigate late payments, we should also ensure that we only look at cases that have finished and are not running, which may eventually be paid to ensure accuracy of our analysis. This is also very easy with the built-in case categorization feature, and by filtering the end activities, we can see that 70% of cases have finished. Now we can filter for cases that have finished and are marked as late payment using the metrics filter, and save both late payment cases and on-time payment cases as views. With both views, we can now leverage process compare to help us understand the differences between late and on-time payments. In the process compare tool, we can choose the late payment view to compare with our on-time payment view. And in the output, the green activities and edges are those that are shared across both views, while the red is only present for late payments. We see that three claims were late because it required reapproval, but it represents an edge case. Absolute numbers are not very useful here, so let's look at percentages instead. Now we see something interesting. While the frequency of other activities is not very different between late and on-time payment, late payments have a much higher frequency of escalation at 54%. Drilling in, we can see that there is a much higher likelihood of escalations, 68% for late payments versus 14% for on-time. This is a great insight, but escalations are not something we can simply avoid, and there are various reasons why escalations occur. What we really want to do is predict whether a claim will be paid late. Let's ask my assistant on what to do. Copilot recommends a variety of actions to assist in our goal. Some of them we've already done, but it also recommends doing a root cause analysis and then building a predictive model using historical payment data as training sample. This is great. Let's start with root cause analysis, or RCA, on finished cases. I can select late payment as my metric and only the influencing factors from my data. And RCA shows me that region is the most influential factor, where a subset of 30 regions account for the majority of late payments. In addition, I can look at other influential factors like claim type, where one specific claim type is causing more late payments than others. I can also continue to drill into other influential factors, like within those 30 regions, lower amounts actually contribute to higher likelihood of late payment. Now that we have a good understanding of the influential factors, let's build our predictive model. I can export my historical process data at the case level with the relevant columns as well as my late payment custom metric and easily import it into Dataverse as a new Dataverse table, where you can see it correctly detected the columns and data types using Copilot. I can then navigate to AI models and create a new prediction model. Use the table that we just created and late payment as the outcome we want to predict. Through a simple low-code intuitive interface, I'm able to start training my model. Once the model is trained, I can review its performance, which has a rating of B and correctly predicted 87% of actual results. And the most influential factors are aligned to what we discovered from RCA, including region, cost, and claim type. Let's publish it and use it in a flow. I can create a flow with the help of Copilot to trigger on a new claim settlement, then use the AI model I just created, provide the relevant data as input to the model, and if the prediction response is true, send the team's notification to expedite the claim to ensure on-time payment. I can verify the flow runs correctly by testing it and seeing the results in my team's notification channel. Now that we have discovered and acted upon the many compliance issues uncovered through process mining, let's use that data to build out a custom Power BI dashboard to monitor future compliance issues as well as track improvements. Power Automate Process Mining allows for publishing the process model directly to your existing Power BI workspace. Once the process is linked, we can navigate directly to the generated report in that workspace. From here, you can edit the report and access all of the data that was generated by process mining, including new views as well as the new custom metrics that was created so it can be easily added to a Power BI visual through drag and drop. In a short time, I'm able to create a custom compliance report that tracks all of the KPIs we created, including conflict of interest, non-compliant claims, on-time payment rate, and problematic regions. With Copilot and Power Automate Process Mining, we're able to identify compliance issues. With the combination of Power Platform and AI, we're able to build low-code solutions to mitigate them through early detection, and with the integration with Power BI, we were able to monitor the improvements.